bothers me when the guards get to acting like the broads. Guess every team doesn't come complete with niggas like ours. That's why I see no need to compete with niggas like y'all. I just ask that when you see me, you speak up, nigga, that's all. Don't be ducking like you never wanted nothing. It's feeling like rap changed. There was a time it was rugged. Back when if a nigga reached, it was for the weapon. Nowadays, niggas reach, just to study records. Spaghetti bolognese in the Polo Lounge. Me and my G from D.C., that's how I roll around. Might look like, but we heavy though. You think Drake would pull some shit like that, you never know. $1 million meetings in the Polo Lounge. Me and my man Oliver North, that's how I roll around. Shorty wanna tell me secrets about a rap nigga. I tell that bitch it's more attractive when you hold it down. Kobe bout to lose 150 M's. Kobe my nigga, I hate it, had to be him. Bitch, you wasn't with me shooting in the gym.
Bitch, you wasn't with me shooting in the gym.
Tell Lucy and I said, fuck it, I'm tearing holes in my budget. Bag of light, we in public, so take a ass out in public. Ordered it up for late, told her butterflies, she'll love it. She used to soda and nuggets, she really just tired sucking. I've been hitting my pinnacle, you a pussy identical. You like the fucking finish line, we can't wait to run into you. But let me get my mind off that young rich motherfucker getting mine off rap with my nigga.
Who hotter than me? Got a question for the street. Who hotter than me, nigga? Who hotter than me? Got a question for the street. Who hotter than me, nigga? Who hotter than me?
How you feel, haters? Your hate didn't work. Thanks to y'all, I'm the hottest thing on earth. Got the bitches in the goons, I'm the first. Worth a couple meals, but still in the burp. Can't be flushing through the fence, y'all in no shirt. I hold bond, go to cold on the first. Blue life in the streets, I done reverb. See me on fire, hate, I know it gotta hurt. I'm so hood, classic verse. Wanna talk business, what's in the purse? Might gon' die, won't get murdered. Who hotter than me? Nobody, sir.
Got a question for the street. Who hotter than me? Who hotter than me, nigga? Who hotter than me? Got a question for the street. Who hotter than me? Who hotter than me, nigga? Who hotter than me? Got a question for the street. Who hotter than me? Who hotter than me, nigga? Who hotter than me? Got a question for the street.
I got a question for the streets. Who hotter than me?
What's good, Trek?
What's good, bro?
Chilling. What we doing here?
Man, it's whatever, man. You know, look, man. I was gonna come on the show and address some stuff, but I'm gonna let that go.
Yeah.
I don't want to let it go. I don't want to, but on behalf of my bros, I'm going to let it go. Yeah.
It's tough because there's some things we can say.
Listen. I'm just drop the story on. This dude trolled me on Twitter today. You know what I'm saying? I don't want him to get these goddamn jokes mixed up that I be putting out of what the fuck, you know, could actually happen. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah,
at me.
Yeah.
My location is on, bro. That's all I got to say, man.
Mm-hmm.
At me. My location is on. I leave it at that, bro. I ain't going to get into the altercations or nothing like that, but at me. Don't be in that ring. You know what I'm saying? That's all I ask.
Yeah, I hear you. I mean, I be staying out of it, but, man, what's these tweets about? I mean, man, I'm looking into some of the shit that you was posting. I saw one that was wild. Well, something about tonsils.
come on, man. That's been like a... All right, look, man. Storming down here in the Ville yesterday and shit, so...
Oh, no, I got it. Hold up. You say, y'all woman put y'all finger in your own booty when you get hit
oh my
from
God.
Thy backside?
No. I asked that because I had accidentally started watching porn and shit. And
accidentally? What did you do?
Yeah, bro.
I was on the app?
Nah, because I was trying to look up some Bible verse or something, and Nigga, I don't know. I guess I pressed like the wrong thing, man, and then I ended up oh, she's freaky.com or something, page 3, the 4th video, you know what I'm saying? And so chick, she getting smacked from the back and shit, so yo, she put her finger in her own ass. I'm like, wow, bro, like, that's some next, you know, that's some level 10 shit right there. And I need all of it, you know what I'm saying? Like, hey,
Jesus.
I need to see that in person. I need to see that in person, you know what I'm saying? That's what I need, bro. You know what I'm saying? So.
Now, do you use your ring finger for that? I'm curious. What finger did she use?
You know what? So she did use a ring finger. And when she pulled it out, the ring got stuck. But I'm like, you know what I'm saying?
Like, see, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Straight like that. Yeah, dog. Like, grand champion. Straight like that, bro. You know what I'm saying? So,
yeah. Hey, what's this one about? It was posted 21 hours ago. I want my dick sucked until it dissolves. Balls too.
Look, man, like, this is the problem that I have sometimes. Well, not. Generally, I'm just speaking in a general, man, but you know,
you're
I'm
not.
Get the head sometimes, and you, I'm just saying, you get some head sometimes, and it's like, yo, like, that shit is dope, but you done already? Like, you know what I'm saying? I need you to be down there until my shit disappear. You know, you ever seen a bitch eat a fruit roll-up, and that shit just be gone? You know what I'm saying? Like, it dissolves and shit. That's what I want to happen in my shit. You know what I'm saying? Balls, too. When I go take a pee, I don't want to see nothing down there. I don't even want to be able to pee when I go, you know what I'm saying? I need my shit to be gone, bro. You know what I'm saying? So.
That sounds like a health hazard. That don't sound enjoyable.
Hey, I know. Yeah, but I'm willing to risk it all, though, bro. You know what I'm saying? That's where I'm at with my shit. I don't give a fuck.
Jesus. You a wild, wild man. You a wild man.
And I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed of it either, bro.
I know you're not.
Whatever the fuck, man. Look, GDP, listen. The way I see it, man, we only got one life to live, bro. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to, shit needs to start happening that I never seen before, bro. So if I get my shit sucked and that shit dissolves, I'm like the man around this bitch if that shit happens, though. You know what I'm saying? What other motherfuckers going to be like?
Well,
yo,
yeah, I mean,
in
South Carolina, they probably still doing just missionary.
No.
So
first
I'm
of all,
sure,
hey, listen. But look, this is the thing. First of all, No, we beyond that. But don't get it wrong, missionary is dope, bro. You know what I'm saying? Her legs, listen, bro, the silhouette, when you're in the dark beating a woman down, bro, when you got the silhouette of her legs up in the fucking air and you up in that shit, bro, that shit is lovely, man. That's a beautiful sight. So I'm not mad at missionary, bro. You know what I'm saying? That shit is top 5 for me. You know what I'm saying? That's my shit. You know what I'm saying? So
You say top five like there's like multitudes of positions, like there's infinite possibilities.
Don't trip, because listen, you ever been to the sex store called Spencer's?
Nah. I don't know. Tim is walking.
Don't lie.
But
we'll talk about it. We'll talk about it after the show. Nah, it's a
nah,
sex store called Spencer's, man.
They
got a book in there, bro. That shit got like 300 positions in it. But it's some bullshit, because motherfuckers doing headstands on their eyebrows and shit. Like, man, ain't nobody about to be fucking doing that. Like, bitch, you standing on your eyebrows. Like, how the fuck am I supposed to, like, no. You know what I'm saying? But there's enough, bro. I be making up bullshit, you know, so I'm a creative ass motherfucker. So I be in this motherfucker damn about to kill myself, bro. Like, my damn bones be popping and shit. I be trying all this bullshit, but like I said, man, I only got one life to live, so fuck it. I don't give a fuck, bro. I'm a fuck on the ceiling fan one night. That's where I'm at with my shit.
Jesus Christ.
Listen,
I'm going to tell you
straight up. I'm going to keep it real, bro. GDP shit ain't get so bad, bro. Shit getting so bad, man. Now, look, bro. When I do the 6-9 now, I'm the motherfucker that's upside down, and I don't give a fuck, bro. You know what I'm saying? I'm upside down with it. You know what I'm saying? Oh, shit.
Hey,
I know that's hard for you to
comprehend. Nah, it's not. I'm trying to set up this shit with the guests, but
Oh, we got
yeah,
guests listening already.
I'm an adventure. Huh?
We got some people listening already?
Nah.
Damn, I'm mad. I wanted them to hear this. Because I was going to try to damn inspire them, you know what I'm saying, to step out on faith. Okay.
Yeah, nah, my fault. All right, pardon me. Yeah, but, nah, you an adventurous. I see you, bro. You like the Picasso. You know, you trying to just paint pictures.
Appreciate it, bro. If you can't paint a picture, what's
nah,
that, bro?
Nah, that wasn't
make
a compliment.
It is a compliment. It is. I'm fucking Picasso. You know what I'm saying? If you can't paint your own picture, you make a stain on somebody else's. You know what I'm saying?
Jesus Christ, you trying to make stain on people? One
hey,
at a time?
Listen, I'm just saying, innocent bystanders get hit all the time, bro.
Jesus
now, if I'm wrong,
Christ.
Then you fucking tell you my boy. You just tell me I'm wrong. But innocent
nah,
bystanders
I'm not.
Get hit.
Man,
you innocent
pervert,
bystanders
son,
get hit
but...
out, GDP. Look. What? First of all,
hey, you,
hold
hey,
on, hold
hey,
on, hold
enough,
on.
Enough. Enough. Hey, we got the guest on. I don't know where Kligger at. I think he got in trouble.
Late as always.
But, yeah, big fact. But, you know, we usually got, like, a multitude of men on this podcast pause, you know, just bullshitting. Mm-hmm. But we figured it's about time that we got a woman up here. And Trigger's very familiar with this lady.
Oh, chill. It's only been 2 days, right?
But you know, without further ado, you know, hey Trick, can we say this like the first lady of what we doing here, radio?
Facts, bro. She's the first man. She's an innovator.
Am I jumping out the window?
Nah, you definitely not. She's an innovator, man. She's the first, bro. Respect that shit.
All right. I'm going to get her on.
Yeah, you got to get her on, please.
Hey, you got to quick. That's Trigger, not me. I'm just chilling.
What? I'm just here, you know.
You sound like you know.
GDP. Hey, look. Hey, hold
yo,
on.
Yo.
Hey, look. She came online. Hey, I done changed my motherfucking voice and everything, yo. I done switched my voice up and shit, you know what I'm saying? But, yeah.
Sure did.
Man.
Went down like a couple
what's
octaves.
Who I got on the line?
I mean, you know what it is. It's your girl, Young Shay, also known as Bree, to people who know me. But people don't like Bree because she kind of, you know, kind of crazy. So I'm going to be whoever y'all want me to be today.
I want the real. I want both of them. I need both of them here. You know what I'm saying? Like bring both of them this year. Bree and Shay. I need both of them. I want both of them to show up. And we got on
Trick.
That. Man,
Trick. It ain't even 6 o'clock here. Sit
Trick.
Down, man.
Bro, all I said. Listen, okay. All I said was, I mean, listen. She came in here. She described some personalities. I need both of them to see. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? See which one is gonna create the most chemistry.
The question is, can you handle either of them, though? That's the real question.
Hold up.
Fix my fucking mic! Fix my mic, hey!
Hey. Fix my fucking mic.
Yeah, talk your shit, Shay.
I'm just saying, but... Homie one is mic fix. That sounds like, you know, the number one thing we gotta do right now.
No, my mic is good. Mic is good.
I'm not about to play with you.
Oh, and I ain't gonna play with you neither. My
no,
man, look, said it. Hold on, say that again.
That's cause you can't.
Come on, baby, you a star. I love
this
you the way you
said,
are.
Come on, baby.
But I love you enough not to leave the way you are. I'm on your side. Bree, Shay, whichever one you prefer, I'm on your side, man. You know what I'm saying? Talk your shit. I'm listening. You talk, I listen.
This nigga,
yo,
you
Clay,
sound
you
like the type of that sends money on Cash App.
I sound like a nigga that'll send Cash App.
No, I said you sound like a nigga who sends girls on cash and talk about I'm gonna listen to you all day. What bills you need, baby? I'm on your side.
Oh no, I'm not. I am not him. Where you from though?
Compton.
You from Compton? You from West Side Compton?
I'm from, and we ain't got to get into specifics about where I am or where I stayed. It's not from Compton.
It's all good. I find everybody, so it's whatever. Really don't matter.
Trick trying to get the coordinate.
Oh, man.
Yeah,
hey, GDP, you know I can get
those.
I can get those. You know I can get the coordinates, man. You know where I work at. You know,
yo.
So.
Yo.
Is this click?
Yep.
Oh, my God. There goes my shine. Hey, Clay, what you doing? What that nigga Cole said, I was just about to come strong with my rap.
Hey, Trig, I get on and you talk about Cash Apps.
Yeah.
What?
Cash Apps.
Bro, what are you talking about, man? Bro, I'm out, man. That nigga's tripping.
Hey. You know, long hair, don't care. You all right? You all right over there,
yo,
brother?
Nigga, listen. You know how I be, man. You know how I be, dog. You know me. You know what I'm saying? But I thought she said I sound like the kind of nigga that be sending the Cash App. I'm like, no, first off, I'm broke.
You do?
Oh, hell no. You know what I'm saying? No, nigga.
You do.
Sweet.
I probably sent him a little money to my concubines and shit.
Wait, I'm
talking.
Let Shay talk.
I have a question. Yeah. So, who else is... Oh, I know Craig's on. I know Trig's on because, you know, he done changed his voice 17 times since I, you know, tapped
Facts.
In.
Facts. Get used to that.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
Let me call on him. Clay, can you stop, bro? Like... Oh my God!
Yeah, I'm laughing. You a funny guy, man.
No, nah, man, I'm good, man. Y'all go ahead, man. I'm good.
He needs some help.
He can't help him. Trig is
disappointed. Hey, click.
Yeah.
Trig had so high expectations for this, and it's already going down sad.
It's not though. I'm optimistic. It's really not, though. You know what I'm saying?
Trig got a haircut. He washed his hands. He washed his shoelaces. He was ready for this.
I'm about to be fresh as fuck for this episode.
He got dressed in his prom outfit for the episode. Jesus.
Yeah, nigga. Yeah, and made sure my socks was matching. What are we talking about?
Trig dressed like Martin the first time he met Gina.
Bro, listen. Speaking of that shit, bro, that episode was funny as fuck, bro. Oh shit, it's like my top five favorite episode, but that's for another time. Shit.
What
we talking about?
Hold up. So we got Shay up here because she has some things she wanted to discuss. So I'm gonna just give the floor to her and she can run with it. So it's on you.
All right, cool. So I mean, you know, you saw how things kind of went up and switched up as soon as, you know, I'm gonna just use you as an example. How Trigger, you know, done switched up. Heard I was in here. So I have a question. Guys, I'm going to call y'all niggas, but guys, why do y'all switch up when you're around women? Because I realize I work, you know, customer service, all that stuff. Why do y'all turn stupid, no offense, as soon as a girl starts talking to you? Cause, like, you don't know how to form words. Or why do things get different when women are put into the equation?
I answer that.
Yeah,
and my exact example would be, the first ship that I was on was an all-male ship. When I got to San Diego, it was an all-male ship. You could say certain things. Everything was like, whatever, whatever. Nobody really cared. But when we went on deployment, they added, like, Marine females. They added Air Force females. As soon as they added females into the equation, people started talking louder. people started, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, people started having dance battles in the middle. I'm like, yeah, ain't none of y'all never used to dance before. I didn't even know.
Top blocking.
So now you like Chris Brown. Now you like Omarion. The dude walked through. He saw a girl. Hey, look, he saw a girl on the mess deck, and he did the whole, you know, Omarion's touch video. He did that all through the whole mess deck. I'm like, he doing that because there are females here. A guy cannot even like a female. He cannot even think she's attractive. But if he could get her attention away from another guy, he gonna do it just because. That's exactly why. But go ahead, Trey. Go ahead and lie, Trey. Go ahead, Trey. Shit turn to lie.
Listen. First of all, look, Queen, you're not smart. You just trying to tell her you was in the Navy and shit. Like, let's get that out of the way. Like, let her go in the Navy right quick. But, like, honestly, I don't really switch up. You know, I'm the same. Like, I act like this even before she got here. You know what I'm saying? Like, me personally, I don't feel like I have to do that shit. You know what I'm saying? Because when it comes to women, I don't really think there's no losing with me. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't feel like I can take them off. For real.
I'm not laughing at you. No, that should just sound funny as hell, man.
No, but I'm laughing at you. The reason why is because as soon as you realized I had, you know, tapped in and all that shit, you was like, hey, y'all, you see how I done switched up my voice? See how I done did this?
But I was being facetious. I was being facetious, though. Like, because if it was real, I wouldn't even say anything about it. You know what I'm saying? So I was just bringing attention to it. Like, let me go ahead and hype myself up. But nah, I didn't switch up. Like,
so, Clicker, a couple of seconds ago, didn't you just say that men like to, you know, bring the attention of the woman to him? So basically what I'm hearing is you're right?
But listen. But Pete. Listen. You was already going to give attention because we up here together. So that was automatic. It would be different if it was just, if I caught you somewhere else. Shit would be different then, but like, the attention thing ain't really a necessity, you know what I'm saying? Like, we up here all together, so that's going to happen anyway.
Hold up, Trick.
So if I disregarded everything you had to say from here on out, it wouldn't bother you?
If you say that again?
If I, you know, disregarded everything you have to say from here on out, it wouldn't bother you?
I'd be mad as fuck. Especially if you start talking to everybody else. Hell yeah, I'm going to be like, yo, what the fuck? I might hang the fuck up. Like, I'd be mad as shit. Like, I'm not going to sit here and lie about that. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'd be mad as shit. You disregard my shit. Like, hold on, man. You know what I'm saying? I feel like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm a cool guy. I feel that about myself. I feel like I'm pretty cool. So, hell yeah, I'm going to be mad as fuck if you disregard my shit. Let me tweet that, by the way. I'm going to remember that shit.
So, basically, like you said, you just proved exactly what I was saying to be correct.
Whose goddamn side are you on, man?
Nah, Trick be doing everything for attention, yo. I guarantee you, if there was no females on Twitter, he would not be posting I'm trying to be tonsils deep in a midget stripper. Like,
you
got it.
You goddamn right, I wouldn't think that. Bro, but listen, this is the thing, bro. Like, Clegg has been following me for maybe years, bro. Clegg know, like, of course, bro. I like bringing attention to my tweets. I'm like, I feel like I'm like a Hall of Fame tweeter. So of course, I like bringing attention to my shit, bro.
Jesus.
Like, listen. Like, sometimes it's kind of like, listen, bro. I be thinking, like, no lie, man. You be thinking, like, yo, if I say some super nasty shit, somebody gonna slide in my DMs. But GDP, you seen my DMs before, so you know what be going down sometimes. You know what I'm saying? So
yeah,
like,
a whole lot of headshots.
Yeah. Hey. Wait. But leading up to that, I think sometimes people take, like, certain shit for, like, more than what it is, though. Like, you dig what I'm saying? Like, Trig could tweet that, but I know Trig, like, you know what I'm saying? Just, like, Trig and I know each other's, like, life or, like, either home life. So if he's tweeting he want to do X, Y, and Z, I'm like, son, come on, son. Or he'll look at me and be like, yo, what we doing here? Like, I know, you know what I'm saying? Like, certain things like that.
Yeah.
Sometimes you can't look at tweets. We be doing it because it's funny, and sometimes it might be over the line or reckless, but it is what it is. The shit is funny, and, like, take that for what it is. But also, but on a flip side, and this is to anybody that be tweeting, look, this is to anybody that be subtweeting or doing this, that, and the third. This is a public service announcement. That shit could get you fucked up. Like, stop playing.
Yeah.
Like, at the end of the day, we all hear to laugh and joke. But, like, certain things is, like, corny, and I don't feed into it like a lot of people might do or might want me to do. And I see it. I just don't feed into it because that's corny, and that's, like, little kid stuff. Like, at the end of the day, I'm not going to ever see you. People see my location. They see that I'm in Japan. They know me and the family going to Italy or whatever you want to say. They know I'm not going to be in the continental United States. Look, people were on library mode. This is what I'm trying to tell you. People was on library mode when I was in San Diego for 5 years. Nobody talked. There was no click of this, click of that. But when I go overseas or move around, now everybody want to talk about me or subtweet.
That's a, hey, Clint. Like, honestly, man.
Hey, hold on, Trick. Click. So you,
yes.
is this what you're saying right now?
It ain't gonna be that, so. It ain't gonna be that, so. It ain't gonna be that. It ain't gonna be that.
It ain't gonna be that. That sounds just like Trey. It ain't gonna be that, though.
It's not. But that's the thing. But look, what kind of like got me though? Like, I don't like niggas like that, bro. Like, you're a grown ass man. Don't fucking sell tweet my homies and shit. So I'm like, yo, ask the nigga. But listen, I told a nigga like me, I don't really get into it with Twitter niggas, bro, because honestly, I got I got niggas who don't like me for real that'll fucking try me like that. You know what I'm saying? So I beat the shit out of one of these niggas on Twitter, bro. So I already know what the fuck I do to them, but that shit be pissing me off. Bro, I swear to God, I'll fly to Houston and smack that nigga the fuck up. Like, honestly, bro, and I mean that shit. So, but at the same time, I got kids and shit who don't need to see that shit.
Hey,
but
cut it with these fairy tales. Let Shay talk.
Listen, let's not forget, if a grown-ass man has the time to subtweet about you, let's remember, niggas can be bitches too, all right?
That's a fact.
If you're taking the time out of your day to talk about a grown-ass man while you another grown-ass man, like, it's one thing to talk about somebody, but to sub them, like, that's pussy shit, you feel me? Like,
facts.
My location's on.
Right.
You know what's up, because if I was in your neighborhood, that's pillow talking shit. I don't fuck with that. Like, someone I know, I'm going to get fucked up for that shit. Because, again,
right.
I can be really nice, or I can be that bitch that fucks you up with a smile.
Facts. But, you know, like Click, you know that's not my style and shit. Like, that's not me. Click, you know that's not my style and shit, bro. Like,
I was trying to tell you to chill because, like, shit like that, I'm like, of course I see it. I see it, but I'm not going to react because that's what people, you know what I'm saying? That's what people want. Just like what's the dude's name? The 6ix9ine dude. Hey, look, just like the 6ix9ine dude, people get mad at him for trolling, and they know he's trolling. I'm like, yo, you know he's trolling, and you know he's not going to do nothing, but you still react and get mad. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, when you really think about the big picture, you dude is talking to himself. You're not talking to me, and you would not tell me that, or nobody that I know, if I was standing in front of you. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, at the end of the day, if we're going to keep it real, this is not no tough guy shit or nothing like that. The average person is not prepared or built for the type of, like, stuff like that type of level. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's cool. Let them talk. That's what they're going to do. They got thumbs. They got thumbs to tweet, Trey. You know what I'm saying? That's what they can do.
And I don't even know why anyone would want to fight Clicker because you tear your shirts in half by looking at them. So
Jesus. That's
not something I would want to do. I'm not about to say
but everybody on Twitter got guns, remember? Everybody are shooters. Everybody is going to shoot people. And
you all right?
Hey,
you all right? You've been doing all right? You got out the hospital good or what?
Dude said that's why I don't like when people do like I'll post a picture and then somebody will take it and put like if he slaps your mother or slaps your girl on the ass, what are you gonna do? And immediately I say, hey, don't do. Don't do that because. You're gonna have 1,700 people saying how they're going to shoot me, they're going to do this, they're going to do that. And I didn't know so many people had guns. Hey, everybody on Twitter got
guns.
Guns. Everybody.
They got the battle rap.
Wait, how y'all all got guns?
They got the battle rap.
Everybody got I know Trigg got guns. Hey, Trigg's in the Army. I'm pretty sure he has a gun or two, and they legal. Y'all got guns?
I don't.
Why are you gonna shoot me? I'm not
talking about it. Exactly. Exactly.
Hey, so wait, hold on. Hey, Shay.
Yeah, what's up?
Hey, so not saying where you work, but I guess you're in customer service, right?
Yeah.
Like, so I guess, is it in like a mall or like something like that? Because you were like, people come in and you can sell them stuff and that they might not particularly want to buy. I'm not buying shit, by the way.
Nah, trust me, you won't buy something if I'm talking to you. Especially like when people call
hey,
in,
if
like,
I...
if you what?
I go to the mall. I go to the mall to buy some shoe cleaner, and you over here selling vacuums. I'm not buying no vacuum. I don't need a vacuum.
Hey,
goddamn dirt devil.
Hey, I ain't even gonna hold you. Hey, click. I ain't even gonna hold you. I'm gonna get my shoes clean and just say I'm not interested.
Hey, they
mean,
called
bro.
Me one time. Hey, they called me one time. I think it was my son's birthday. We were walking in the mall or something like that. He had just got a haircut. And you know how, like, the dudes sit at the corner, and they like, hey, my brother, my shoes wasn't dirty at all. But he was like, you want to keep your shoes
yeah.
clean? And I'm like, I guess. And he was like, hey, you could buy this and blah, blah, blah. And I bought it. And it actually worked, which pissed me off because it pissed me off that they work really well.
That's pretty yeah, sad. Sure. But look though, I went to the mall on break and niggas asked me that I want my shoes clean. Like, bitch, I'm in uniform. Like, what the fuck? Like, no, nigga, I don't
work at the mall. Crazy.
Hey, wait, my bad. Shay, go ahead, answer.
Yeah.
Oh, my
yeah.
bad.
Nah, okay, like I know exactly what you're talking about. I don't clean the shoes of little kiosk thing. I mean, we have one of those at the mall that I work at. But all the dudes tried getting at me, and I had to curb, like, the whole team. And, like,
I wait, but why, though? Why? Because of the seven-foot dude, or what? Is he 7 feet? Is your boyfriend 7? Is he 7 foot in Tim's, or is he 7 foot in socks?
Nah. not my boyfriend, but he...
Hey, if he's 7 foot in socks, leave that man alone.
Wait a minute.
That man's 7 foot.
Hey, what?
Back.
You better
play basketball
with that height.
No.
Wait a minute.
He's like 6'7".
Oh, shit.
Jesus. See that trick? He's 6'7".
I don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
I'm not going to disrespect him. That nigga, like. Choke slam me and some shit, like, you know what I'm saying? But so
Trick
so,
irritated
so,
Trick Magazine. Trick,
bro,
yeah, Trick Magazine.
I'm really like,
eight.
Yeah, I just get, nigga, I'm sitting here with my motherfucking arms folded and shit, like, damn.
I mean, he be seeing all the stuff that goes down on the TL, like,
down on the but damn,
but see, that's even
so
because you see, hey, wait, you see how dope that is that. People think because you don't, you might not particularly say shit about, like, your life that you're trying
right.
to hide it. You might not be particularly trying to hide it. She don't, like, you just said, you see how I just brought that up to you, Trig? You didn't even know that she had somebody that she was seeing because she don't put it out there like that because
yeah.
people be in your
oh,
business.
Man.
And she just said he sees all of the shit that is tweeted and he cool with it. Like, it's whatever.
Yeah. Yeah, but y'all go ahead and talk to me, man. I need a few minutes to recover, man.
Hey, Trig has plans to fly out to Cali tonight. Like,
I don't be talking about, listen, I got a whole wife, you know what I'm saying? Like, but my wife don't be tripping. She follow me on Twitter, you
the
know what I'm saying?
The man at the kiosk at my mall has a wife, too, and he still try getting at me, so what's your...
Yeah,
so.
What's talking
wrong
about,
with
Trent?
Yeah,
what's my wife?
Like,
no, hold on. I'm not saying it, like, I mean... Don't even get me started, like... Please. Nah, I'm not saying it, like...
Hey,
that.
We don't need you to incriminate yourself. So.
No, I'm not going to do that. I'm just... Informational person is like, I mean, purpose
yeah,
is like, I got a wife and shit, like.
Yeah, learn from my mistake.
No, GDP, you ain't make more mistakes than me. Believe me.
Oh,
nigga,
I
couldn't even sleep on the couch. I wasn't good enough to be in the house.
You be talking some bio shit. Oh, I almost, man, let's not get into it. I just got
fact,
out of
but the thing
house.
Is, my woman, my lady followed me, so she know what the fuck I be saying. Like, that's why, like,
Back to the original question. So Shay, you said they see you working there, and they're not trying to buy whatever you're selling, but they're trying to holler. Are you saying to the public, to the What We Doing Here community, that you have gotten men to spend money at whatever place you work at, and they didn't?
Oh, this about to be good.
Oh yeah, all the time. A guy came in with like a kid. His kid was like 4 months old, and I told him like a size 9C.
It's not your fault. You know what? I don't blame you. Like, you know what? It'd be these motherfuckers who feel like, man, if I do this, you know what I'm saying, she's going to give me a chance. Niggas be walking out with a fucking receipt and an attitude, bro. Like, that's all. Like...
And now he got to go home and explain to his girl or his wife why the hell he just spent $1,000 on some bullshit that he didn't need.
Nigga got 13 packs of damn NBA socks. Like, come on, man.
Hey, then he got to go back. Then he got to go back on another day. Shay ain't there and turn it back in.
She worked 5 days a week, so you.
Or like,
hey, if that's me, I'm gonna go back and be like, I'm gonna get her fired. Oh, word?
Hey,
oh, dead ass, you gave me the wrong snap. Now I'm gonna get her fired. She getting fired.
I'm gonna keep it real. I'm gonna go back home and I'm gonna call the motherfucking store. Like, I'm gonna go home and call the store. Yeah, y'all got somebody by the name of Shay there. May I speak to her, please?
No, people do call in.
Shay here giving out fake snaps.
No, y'all.
Yeah, you're selling cardigans.
There's this old man. He's like in his 70s, and he like always comes into my job. And people are like, yo, Shay, your stalker, he's back, he won't leave, he's requesting you. I'm like, y'all need to do something, tell security to come. Like, I had to move locations because people were actually coming to my job specifically for me to try to talk to me. Yeah, things like that. And
you must be bad in person, boy. Shit. Who you work at?
Sometimes it is scary because like this guy tried hollering at me. He was like, "Well, I know who you work. I'm just keep coming every day to see you." I'm like, "Please don't do that because you're gonna get shot."
That's crazy though. Like, I'm not gonna be on no type of stalking shit. Like, I'm not. Yeah. Come on, man. You showing up the motherfucker's job stalking him and shit, my nigga. Like, come on, man.
Yeah, it's weird.
That's kind of like on a serious note. That's kind of like. That's really, like, shady. It's, like terrible. Like,
yeah,
like niggas burning their gas to go stalk somebody. Like, come on, bro. You don't eat. You be like, nah, I got to go. Like, my nigga, your gas light on. You still, like, fuck it. Like, that's terrible. I'm not doing that.
He had to pick his kids up for their visitation. Right, he left his kids outside for the visitation to go stalk her at work. That's wild.
They done finished their kids' meal and everything. Like, I'm not doing that. I ain't even going to my wife, y'all. Let me fuck up.
Oh, I like my customers. They will come in, like, some people, instead of, like, buying shoes, whatever, they'll, like, buy me food. They'll ask me if I'm hungry. I'm like, yeah, sure, why not? Then I'm like, you know.
I'm sick of these niggas. Adam, so I can know who you're talking about. I'm sick of this shit.
I don't follow them. I don't do nothing of that.
I'm fed the fuck up, yo, with these niggas setting all these goddamn standards. See, it's their fault, man. For real, man. They be doing this shit. Like, they be doing this shit. And this is why a lot of... Never mind. I'm not leaving. Get involved.
Listen. Let me tell y'all something. A girl who knows that she can get whatever she wants, she ain't got to ask for it. Like, the girls who are like, oh, cash at me this or do this for me, that's how you know that they don't get nothing. Because I'll get people to hit me up, hey, what's your cash app? Are you hungry? Because I got it like that. I'll walk in the grocery store. Oh,
give her Don DeMarco right quick, bro.
Hey, yeah, give her Don DeMarco. Give her
Don DeMarco.
People do.
That's
the guy. Don DeMarco.
Okay.
Yeah.
Haymakers and shit.
If you gotta ask for it, you got it.
Right, like if she like the way she just said it, if I see that a lot on like social media, I'm pretty sure Cash App wasn't like invented. Like to me, Cash App is invented. Like me and Venom and me GDP and Venom, we bet on a battle and we paid Venom via Cash App. I think that's what it was more or less made for, just like a quick way. But these hoes
was
using
PayPal,
it like some hoes.
I don't got that.
But no,
like,
but please,
yeah,
we even blame the women. Can we blame the women though?
Wait, I was getting to that. It's the men. Like there are men who will just be like, all right, I'm gonna send her like $30 because she said she needs a filling for her nails or some shit like that. And he doesn't even know who she is. He never like really spoke to her. I seen it. I wanted to screenshot it. I saw a girl tweet, I really need a filling or whatever the fuck a filling is on her nails. And then she posted. She posted a Cash App. Like somebody sent her and said, like, thank you, I love my followers. What?
Yeah.
Like seriously? but again, it's not her fault.
Premium,
it's not her
premium
fault if somebody's
Snapchat
gonna do it.
Be terrible too.
What is that? I don't even know what that is.
What, Snapchat premium
that's,
and stuff like that?
The premium one? I don't know. I don't have a Snapchat, but I be seeing it from like these thoughts out here, like pay for my premium Snapchat. Like, what you gonna do with that? You gonna pay to look at?
What is it though?
I don't have a Snapchat. I don't know.
So do you want?
Go ahead, Shay.
I
know you
know
what premium Snapchat is.
I'm gonna fuck you up. Anyway, I know what it is. I don't have one though. A premium Snapchat is basically.
Right.
What? It's like because one of my followers has it, and so she is basically posting her nudes, her in the shower, her playing with herself, playing with toys, things like that, and people are actually buying it. You know?
Shit.
Like,
how much something like that costs? I don't get it. So you got to put like a credit card? I don't get how that works.
I don't either because I don't do it. So, I don't know.
That's,
I guess.
That's sad, though. Like, all this free porno world, bro.
Speaking of that, real quick. I'm going to speak in code. See if anybody follows what I'm saying. If y'all remember a certain female who had a good amount of followers who liked coleslaw. Does anybody know who I'm talking about? Anybody know who I'm talking about?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Trig?
I've
seen a few of them.
Trig,
so I'm trying to break it down because I don't know.
Well, anyway.
Talking about. Anyway, keep going.
Anyway, there was a time where it was just weird. Like, I would see certain things, and I'm like, there's no way that this girl is not like, I didn't see like a Cash App. I didn't see none of that. So I'm like, it just seemed too like strange. And then one day we woke up, and in a group chat, they sent that. And it was all up and down the timeline. I'm like, it all makes sense now.
Oh,
so basically,
okay.
Yeah, there you go.
It was lovely.
So basically, she was, but I guess the guy that exposed it, she was sending him like, he was like paying for like her nudes or whatever, but she was already sending them out. So he thought that he was the only one getting them, and he's paying her for them, but they was out to everybody. I'm like, what the fuck?
I'm not listening, bro.
If
I ever do that, y'all beat my ass. Right, I'm telling you.
Hey, how we gonna know, Trey?
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, you know I'm gonna tell you. Like, hey, come on, come on, right? You know. But I'm just saying. Hey, look. So it's this other chick on Twitter. I ain't gonna say her name, but like, she be like. I think she'd be doing private sessions, like, for niggas who be paying. Do y'all think that shit is real? Like, they really be flying out fucking these dudes for money and shit?
Some people do. I mean, okay, look, this is how I feel about it. All right. So, I don't care. You do what you do as long as you're safe and testing all that stuff. That's what matters the most. You know, me, my man, I have sex with him for free. other girls are getting paid to do what I do for free. You feel me?
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Like,
why?
Who are we to judge? Like, that's the oldest profession in the world, prostitution. It really is.
Yeah, them harlots. Them harlots it's and Jezebels.
Oh,
hey, Cleve.
Hey.
You ever bought a prostitute?
Yeah.
And don't lie.
Nah. No, dead ass.
Hey,
and, I've been on three.
Hey, I almost did once.
Hey, no, I've been on 3 8-month deployments, and nah. I've seen it. I've seen it a lot. They were everywhere.
I've never seen it.
This is what I would say. If you're overseas and you in the military and you want to go out and buy a prostitute, by all means. But if you buying pussy in America
at home,
you a goddamn creep. In America,
hey, at home.
Click. I ain't about to buy. Hey, listen.
Hey, you buying? Hey.
I'm from what? I'm not doing that. Damn, a pussy. No. I got $30
right now. Hey, hold up.
I got
$30.
$30. Hold up. So they were saying that she'd be having to curve like a whole basketball team. How you be going about that? Because I know, I'm only assuming, them DMs got to be crazy that you be getting at times because there's
sure
people like Trig on Twitter, you know? So,
oh, my God.
How you go about deading that whole situation?
My DMs get pretty scary. One time I woke up and this guy's, entire dick was in my DMs, and I wanted to cry. People would DM me, oh, let me eat your ass, or I want a nut in you. It'll be, 4o'clock in the morning, and, why are y'all like this? Or,
damn.
People, because it's
not me saying that shit.
It's
so wait, so how would you recommend, not particularly to you, but how would you recommend the dude going about that? But again, not to you. Just like if you were giving advice to a guy you work with about how to approach a girl, whether it's in the DM or whatever, how would you be like, hey, don't do this or don't do that or do this or do that?
All right. So let's say you follow a girl and she follows back. If she's liking some of your tweets, engaging with you on the TL, whatever, liking your pictures, you're liking
her
pictures.
That means she wants a beat. That means she wants you to
nigga,
clap.
No, I don't. I mean, it could do that, but it's you want to be some girls do oh, let me nut in you. Some girls do straight to the point. Some girls get to know somebody first, build a friendship, whatever. There's girls who are DTS and some girls who want to get to know you a little bit more, and both are fine. I ain't tripping. I support everybody. Do what you do as long as you're being safe. But it's be respectful for the most part, unless she gives you the green light, to get all nasty if that's what you want to do.
No, wait. What if she hop all in his DM talking crazy and he don't want none of that? How does he go about it? Because you just made it seem the guy is always the aggressor.
Well, that's because you asked, would I do with a guy? Now, if there's a girl,
right.
The girl is
definitely
just asked
that.
If a girl is in your DMs and you're not feeling her, just be like, Shawty, I appreciate it, but, I'm not trying to fuck with you
That's not going to work because, see, girls or females deal with rejection a lot different than a dude. Safe, we're going to use Trig because Trig is my man. He's hilarious to use as an example. If Trig hollers at a female, right? And Trig could have just finished telling you how beautiful you are and this, that, and the third. As soon as you curve him, he going to be like, all right, fuck out of here. You was ugly anyway and bald-headed. And he going to go on about his business. He going to go on about his business. A female, if you curve her, she going to be like, oh, well. I feel like a female will take it to, public. You know what I'm saying? Be like, oh, look at this motherfucker. He probably gay anyway. He don't women.
Yeah.
His dick was small. He probably was broke anyway. He can't deal with a real woman. Like,
okay, have y'all seen that thing where, like, the girl had invited the guy over, but the guy didn't want to have sex or anything, and she's like, you must be gay, like, honey. Just, I don't, okay, some people do put their entire being into their pussy. That's what it is. They think if a man don't want to hit it, then a man is gay. Nah, sweetie, he just might not want you. Like, just because some person doesn't want you doesn't mean the next person won't. Like, I get curved. No, I don't. So, but I could get curved by somebody. Like,
y'all see the flex? The mid conversation flex?
I mean, the reason why I don't, okay, let me clarify. The reason why I don't get curved is because I don't put myself out there. I don't like rejection because my ego is going to get bruised. So I don't put myself out there to get curved. I could get curved if I did put myself out there, but because I don't, you know, it is what it is.
But you also got a lot of people who are just about, what's the word when you shoot a lot, volume. Like, I know people who, like, they like, fuck it. I don't care who I hit. I don't care how many times I hit. As long as I hit one, like, I'll shoot 100 times. But let me hit one, and I'm straight. They don't even give a fuck.
Like, okay, I'm not going to say any names, but there was a person that followed me.
Uh-oh.
He was real rude to me on the TL, always rude to me. I'm like, all right, cool, whatever. So I had him muted. Forgot he existed and everything. Then he slid into my DMs talking about, so when you going to let me wipe you up? And I was like, what? Are you... Like, I'm not on Twitter to look for relationships. No, I'm just there for shits and giggles and to, you know, pop off whenever. Because if I can, no one can be my ass. So I can do whatever I want to do. And he was basically, like, oh, let me nut in you. Let me wife you up. And I'm like, no, like, I don't know you. Don't want to do any of that. And he got all real fucking defensive and was popping off at the mouth. And then he unfollowed me. Like, you can unfollow me. I don't care because you did the job for me. But it's like,
well, I don't understand. What did in all honesty, what did he think you were gonna say? Like, okay, yes.
I guess
meet
he was
up.
Gonna be like, yeah. I guess he thought I was gonna be like, like nut in my mouth and pussy and everywhere else. Like, that's what he thought was gonna happen. But he is delusional. But I don't follow him anymore. And yeah.
What the fuck? See, that's what, like. I even know. I'm pretty sure those are like I think women have it worse on like social media by far. I mean, a lot of women put themselves in that position, but a lot don't also. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, men don't have to deal with stuff like that.
Not happy. No. Okay. So my coworker is a dude. A girl came in and she was whispering, or what she thought was whispering. She's like, "Damn, he's fine as fuck. I bet he got bitches all on his dick." And she was like, "I sit on his dick." And he just kind of, like, looked at me to, like, you know, like, when some shit happened, you look at the person closest to you just to confirm that what had happened just happened.
All right.
And so he just went about his business, and she was like, "Oh, he didn't hear me." So the bitch said it louder. So I'm like, bro, he doesn't want you.
Yeah, but like you said, like, some people don't, or especially females. Like I said, I don't think females take rejection very well at all. Like, I don't know. It's the weirdest thing. And
men don't either, considering there's a lot of headlines about men killing women for saying no.
I think when it comes to rejection, like, in a man, it's more or less like, I think it's who it's in front of. Like, you should never, I don't care how good a dude thinks he looks or how good a guy looks to females. If a female is in a group of her friends, don't approach her. Because even if she likes you, or even if she thinks you, even if she likes you or whatever, she gonna try to clown because she got Karen, her big friend, who's gonna be in the middle holding all the bags, who's not dancing, who's ready to go home, gonna be like, "Girl, She gonna be like, girl, don't talk to him. He got wavy hair. I don't trust nobody with wavy hair. I'm ready to go. And then they gonna call on you. Don't approach a female. Don't approach a female in a group. Wait, hey Trigg, look, hey Trigg, that's like Shuni and Pharaoh. Wait till Shuni and Pharaoh is walking off to the bathroom away from the rest of the group, and then you attack.
Hey,
bro.
And hey, Pharaoh, hope,
like a
couple. Oh my god, I didn't say that.
Have you ever seen? I don't know. Like some girls do, you know. They do like flexing in front of their friends. Then when their friends walk away or whatever, they'll be like, oh yeah, but here's my Instagram, follow me. I don't know,
I'm glad I'm wholesome and safe.
Hey, back in the day, hey look, back in the day, like in my 21-year-old clicker days, you meet a girl in the club and she give you her number. Back then, what was it, AOL Instant Messenger? I don't want your AIM. I don't want that. I want your phone number. And you're going to stand here until I call you and I'm going to see if your phone light up. Because we're not playing this game. We're not playing this call me. I get outside and call her later and I'm calling Pizza Hut. I don't want Pizza Hut. Well, why are you giving me Pizza Hut number? You're going to stand here while your phone light up and I'm going to call you. Hey.
And you better put me in your fucking top 8 on MySpace. What the fuck are you talking about?
Right. Before we have a misunderstanding, I need to be in your top 8.
Top 8,
nah,
yo.
I don't give people my number. I don't. I mean, you can get my Instagram or my Snapchat. That's as good as you get.
Oh, I got it. I'm about to screenshot this whole thing.
Damn.
Hold up.
God damn. GDP. Oh, I got it. Jeez.
Hey, listen. Hey. I ain't tell you I ain't really into getting girls' phone numbers, because if I text you, it's like, now you got my number, and I got to put you on the block list when I get off of work and shit. Like, come on, man.
Hey, hold up. Hey, Trigg, we got J-Mac on the line.
Hey,
J-Mac.
I do that with him.
What's good,
what's
bro?
What's up, y'all? What's going on?
Shit.
Hey, how's it going?
What up, kid?
What's up? Hey, I got a couple things on that bitches with the premium Snapchat shit. So, girl popped me on Snapchat. And was like,
hey, hold on, Mac. Mac. Hey, turn Mac mic up. Pass him his water. Let me get his water.
Turn his mic.
He got your water?
Fix my fucking mic.
Fix my mic. Hey.
Tell me up.
All right, Mac. Go ahead. What you say?
Hey, so this bitch hit me with the premium Snapchat, like her whole rule book and guidelines and shit like that. And I was like, what is it? She was like, yo, just give me $25 a month and then I can send you videos of me fucking and playing with my pussy. I said, yeah, that's cool and all, but Pornhub is 5 seconds away.
Talk to her.
It is free. And she was like, yeah, but if you buy this many videos, I come out there and fuck you. I said, so.
Whoa.
Dudes can't. And I was like, so you don't do pussy payment up front? They got to buy the video. She said, yes. I said, so how does that work? So a nigga can't just pay pussy. He got to buy the video. And then if nigga watching your Snapchat, she say they weird. I was like, so you get mad nigga watching your Snapchat, but you just posting the pussy for free.
Exactly. What the fuck am I paying for?
That's what I'm saying, what I'm paying for. I said, I can go fuck a bitch because you watch porn.
I'm about to kill.
Everybody's adult. If you want to pay for some pussy, one way or another, you paying for pussy. In all reality, y'all going out to eat. Hey, y'all going out to eat. You paying? And you happen to have sex later? You pay.
Hey, listen. All I'm saying is, after we get up, I ain't about to be like, here go $50. I appreciate this pussy. That's not about to happen. I'm not doing it like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, nah.
Hey, I'm going to steal it back anyway. You're going to steal it back anyway.
You feel me?
Give it a 50.
Exactly, bro.
Yeah.
And use that guy. I'm going to send a cash app, and then I'm going to cancel that bitch.
Wait, no, I have a question.
She got two notifications.
Yeah.
So, after fucking a girl, have you ever, like, thanked her, like, thank you? Like, after you get your nut or anything?
Trigg has.
Absolutely not.
Trigg absolutely has.
Absolutely not.
Trigg has.
Hey, I have.
But
But look, yeah. But look, that was my woman though. Like, I like to show. I'm not an ungrateful.
What you talking about?
I'm not an ungrateful ass nigga. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna show my appreciation. You know what I'm saying? First of all, it had been a long week. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, yo, I need some of that slash in my life. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, I got that shit and it was lovely. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, I want her to come right.
Trick.
It was good.
Is that what you told the masseuse?
Hey, bro, look. Hey, I'm gonna tell you a story, yo. All right, so long time ago.
Like 3 weeks.
So when I first joined the army and shit, I went to Korea my first duty station. So me and my baby mom, we had broke up and shit. So I'm like, fuck it, I'm going out, I don't give a fuck, right? So at the time, I used to hear about the whole red light district shit, but I didn't know the shit was real. You know what I'm saying? So me and my homeboys, we go out to Korea and we walk up this hill. And I'm like, yo, we going to the bar. This is my first weekend there. I sold out my first weekend, bro. So I'm walking up the hill and I see some Korean bitches standing in the door. Like, what the fuck is this? These bitches like, what the fuck? So I accidentally go in there and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, I thought it was the bar.
Accidentally?
But I'm going there, right? So, yeah. I said accidentally, man. Yeah. Accidentally. So I'm like, yo. What's this in here? But, nigga, I don't really understand that Korean language. All I heard was, like, $30 or something. So I'm like, fuck it. Cool, bro. But look, I got cheated because she sucked my dick with a condom on. I'm like, first of all, bitch, that ain't how this shit go. I'm mad about that shit. And then she fucked me. But you know what? Like, these bitches, they don't. But the thing about this, they don't fuck you to standard. They fuck you to time. Like, bitch, hold on. I'm not finished. I didn't nut yet. Like, what the fuck you mean it's over? You know what I'm saying? So she put me on game and shit. Like, yo, when you do this. And I thank her for that shit, though, man, because I had went back like one more time.
You were showing bad gratitude, huh?
Fact, bro, when she put me on game on how the shit worked, man, that shit, I was real appreciative of that shit. So when I went back, in fact, bro, like, coupons and everything, like, bitch, I get 2 for $8. Get the fuck out my way. Like, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like, for real shit, though, man. So, yeah, I've been grateful. I've been grateful for pussy before, bro. I ain't even sit here and hold you, nigga. Like, hell yeah.
I've been
appreciative again, goddammit.
Hey, man, if it was me, I'd have to consider it.
Nah, but I was about to say, we touched on what not to do, but I'll ask Shay, because none of y'all is females, what would, in your opinion, work? Like, if I was to hop in some female's DM, I don't, and I said, like, damn, girl, I wanna bottle you and rub you on me everywhere. Would that work? Because I've seen Kligger do that, and I don't know.
Have you? Really? Wait, hold on. That's what we're doing?
Shout out Jazz the Rapper.
Hey, Sada, never do a crime with GDP. Hey, never do a crime with GDP. You see how you just threw me out there?
Fuck that GDP.
Really?
Fuck that GDP.
It's on the timeline. What are you doing here?
Oh, yeah. He said you want to rub around like a lotion and shit. I'm like, yo, you going to be smelling like a strawberry, nigga. Like, I should be drinking and shit.
Hold on, my favorite.
Like, that's not hot, boy.
Can I be honest with y'all?
Nah, not really.
If a man was fine, or if he was like a celebrity or whatever, he could DM the girl, "Ayo, bitch, I'm going to make you suck my dick on this day." And the girl will be mad hyped because she thinks
lit.
The dude is cute or whatever. But if you ugly, you have to do a little bit of convincing, like, "Ayo, you know, I think you're really beautiful, you know, blah, 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 whatever. But it's like,
the Kligger technique.
I disagree with that. I disagree.
Oh, no, the double talk, hey, you got to, hey, the double talk technique, the double talk the shit out of.
Facts.
Hey, look, girl, you are all right looking, but you're not the best looking girl I see. Hurry up and give me your number before I don't want it no more. Hurry up.
I don't know. I mean,
so, I got a question for Faye.
Hey, what do you think about? I got a question about for everybody. At a point, I think it was last week. Dick pills at the gas station. I know Trig is on top of the dick pill at the gas station.
Yeah.
Hey, okay, Air. Okay, Air.
Okay, Air. Okay, Air.
Yeah, okay, Air.
So what you saying? Okay, so what you saying? What you getting at? What you getting at?
Trig is despicable,
hey, GDP,
yo.
Hey, GDP, fix my mic. Fix my mic. Fix my mic right quick, GDP.
I'm
about
not.
To get
hold up. I got
no,
you. I got you.
I know what's about to happen.
Hold up.
Holy shit.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man? I'm out, man. That nigga's tripping.
Appreciate it. Listen. Appreciate it, dog. I ain't never had the pills. Listen, I never really took them, but I know they call that. They
never
got some
really.
Shit called the red ant. I'm like, yo, what the fuck are these? Like, you know what I'm saying? But listen, look, I'm going to tell you some real shit, bro. First of all, I'm not going to be wasting my money on my pills. I got home remedies to get my shit, like, together. Don't fucking play with me, Nate. Like, listen, if I know I'm about to get something, if I know it's one of them night shows, like, my kids ain't here, and it's like, yo, damn, this shit going to be romantic. I can't light all these candles and play some music, and I nut before the intro. Like, I can't do that shit. So I'm like, yo, I got some aura gel under the sink. You know what I'm saying?
Hey,
so
Trick me on deployment, telling everyone, yeah, I got that Rhino XL if you need it.
No, I don't say that. You don't know me. You don't know me. Listen. You hear me clean? He don't know me.
Real shit, I'm about to give you the secret, man. Listen. Like, listen, a lot of niggas be like, yo, I'm a
Down the
here we go.
Marco.
It's about fucking time I get some recognition. No,
that was for
take,
me.
Like,
bro.
You take, nah, fuck you. That's for me. You take some Aura gel and put it on your shit, bro. That shit numbs it a little bit. I swear to God, you going forever, bro. And I don't give a fuck. I might do that shit.
Whoa. That's a life cheat code.
No.
Yeah.
Facts, exactly, bro. Listen, she be like, ooh, you going for a long time. Girl, she only knew. That's what she's talking about. I hope she don't go down there. Hope she don't go there. I'm like, damn, I hope she don't go suck my shit, because she can be like, I'm about to be now.
Trick me using that to play Xbox.
Feel me? I know all the secrets. Listen, I don't need to be nothing. I got all these kids floating around here and shit. Nah, man, I'm good on that shit, man. So I let it sit. Like, take my time, dog. I'll put Aura gel on my shit sometimes, and I'm about to go to fucking work. And I got all night. Got a tongue load for her. You know what I'm saying? Like,
Jesus Christ.
What are you talking about?
Hey, yo, say, man.
17 or less.
I had a problem. Where the fuck did this voice come from? Like,
right, he's sound very white.
Hey, I had a problem last night, y'all. And Click and Trick, I know y'all gonna laugh at me, bro. I had a big problem last night, so
I'm probably gonna laugh too.
Hey, this a fam. Hey, Mac, this a family. It's a family, Mac. Go ahead and share.
No, I'm gonna tell you, I had a problem last night, bro. So I took a bitch to the movies, and it was probably me and her, and probably about three more people in there, but we was all spread out. We had the top in the corner, so I pulled my dick out and tell her, you know, just do something with it.
What? Come out. Hold on, nigga. Wait. Hold on. You're not gonna see that. What?
What movie did you go see?
He watches these.
It was
incredible.
You were at the movie.
Nah. It wasn't the Crows. It was the Jurassic World.
Dude, you were at the movie.
No.
I'm at the movie.
That's my dad. That's my nigga. Keep talking. Fuck your shit, dog.
Where's
DeMarco?
Hey, J-Mac,
this
I got a
problem,
question.
Yeah.
J-Mac, was it a real live woman? Was it like a real live woman? Or
GDP, my bitch is bad, okay? GDP, my bitch is bad. We don't need to go there.
Talk your shit, J-Mac. I ain't pressed that. You don't deserve that,
J-Mac. Get him on the line.
Well, hold on, y'all. This is my problem, though. I'm getting to the problem fact, though, bro. So she giving me the hand job, and, like, I go to sleep, and I wake up, and she still give me his hand job. And I'm like, where your mouth at? And she's she was like, it's people in there. But I said, yeah, but where your mouth at, though? She had a jacket. She would put her head under the jacket, but, like, she didn't want to put her mouth on it. I'm like, what's the problem? Like, why these bitches try to be fake freaks all the time, man?
You gonna make her get on the floor with the milk duds and the butter popcorn and shit?
Hell yeah.
She better do something.
The nerve.
No, hey.
Man,
we need
Benji on here. Cause
hey,
y'all got some gentlemen.
Hey, GDP, I done had bitches on the knees on the stockroom and concrete sucking my dick, so do
I know you have. I'm sure you
they
have.
They killed the flower.
Hey Mac, tell them to respect you. Tell them to respect you. Tell them to respect your mind.
Kiss the head.
Damn,
you're
on the concrete. My hand when
yeah.
you see me.
Yeah, hey, we got Tev on. Tev.
What's cracking, man? What we doing here? Y'all niggas is horny, bro.
Fact,
dangerously horny.
Man, hey, look, my wife just texted me and said she horny. As soon as she walk in the door, I'm out, my nigga.
Trigger, bro, I'm concerned for you,
I mean,
dude.
Nah, don't be concerned
yeah,
for
we
me.
We all are.
Be concerned for her.
We all are.
Be concerned for her.
I'm concerned for you, bro.
Everybody concerned for Trigger, boy. I tell you. Fuck y'all concerned about me for? Y'all, you know what?
Exactly.
I'm just saying. I say I'm going to eat a little portion of ass, and all of a sudden, everybody concerned about me. Like,
nah, you don't though. You don't though. You be posting shit like I'm trying to get suffocated by a butthole tonight. What's good? Like you don't do no little ass. Like you be jumping straight out the window, son.
As
like,
I should,
Chris
though, bro. Listen,
shit.
I like to go all out.
Hey, no, check.
I like to go all out,
you
man.
Real quick. Hold on. Nah.
Talk to me.
Like you ever? It's like NBC, like Catch a Predator. They be mm-hmm. Like. Posting, oh, you said this to so and so. Like, that's you. You be saying the most wild shit.
So what's the problem?
If you don't, hey, if you ain't got a problem with it, I mean, shit. That's,
oh,
that's
you.
Know,
you know the difference?
That,
you know
that's
what,
you.
Okay, I know. You know what the difference is, GDP? It's really not a difference, but you're just
the
like,
difference is
like
what?
Who's
what
shooting?
The fuck is that? Not me.
That's gonna be me. I swear to God, is Venom on? Listen, like you're just not public with it, bro. That's all, bro.
You right. Cause,
hey, I got a quick question. Though, hold on. Hey, where are you from with the accident?
I'm from Compton, but no one believes me.
Yeah, I wouldn't believe you either.
Yeah, me neither. Okay,
I do.
Like. Oh, my. Hey, so, Shay, are you Spanish? Are you, like, Hispanic or what?
I do on my mom's side, yeah. Yeah. My family is pretty mixed.
Yo, click.
Yeah. He probably got shot when the things went off for
But, continue with that.
No, like, my Spanish accent comes out when I'm mad, I guess.
Oh, shit.
And so, yeah, I hate it because no one takes me seriously. They're just, like, speak some. I could tell someone I'm getting ready to kill them, and they'll just be like, I'm ready to die. I'm like, that's not helpful.
So, Shay, you a fan of battle rap?
My music... opinions
what type
don't
of question
matter
is that?
You're trash.
I just want to know if she's a fan of battle rap. Damn, bro. Like,
never mind. You get muted.
You're saying,
my
bro.
Music opinions don't matter.
You're supposed to get to know people, right? You're supposed to get to know people. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what are you talking about? Okay, like.
Wait, you said you're a fan of battle rap?
No, I said my music opinions are trash, but my man is working on that. So, get back to me on that. just in general.
No,
just in general.
Yeah. But who's your favorite? Wait. If you had to think, just name one battle rapper that you know.
How am I supposed to name them if I don't know them? I told you my shit's trash.
You don't know any battle rapper? None. Zero.
I mean,
what have you heard?
I do. I know
any?
That. No, you're putting me on the spot, and I'm turning red.
That means that battle rap is not as big. Hey, wait, hold on. This is just an example that to you weirdos in the battle rap community, battle rap is not as big as you think. She doesn't know any battle rappers at all. She doesn't listen to
not
battle
even
rap.
Murder
that
Luke.
Means she could see you on a train. Hey, look, hey, she could see you on a train or panhandling outside like probably most of y'all do because y'all ain't got no money. And she ain't going to know who y'all are. Battle rap is not as big as y'all want to make it think, but I love battle rap. Amen. Continue.
Well, I mean, I've been seeing y'all tweeting about battle rap and stuff like that. So, you know, I'll pay attention to some of the stuff y'all say. I know someone said something about needing one mic and whatever. That's all I know.
One mic.
Pay attention.
That was mine, nice, by the way.
Huh?
Hey, Trick. Hey, Trick. Nice. Trick, that means don't, when you got a female in the car, don't connect your aux and put a verb on, thinking that you're doing something.
Right.
Don't talk about it.
Because not all people know what battle rap is, Trick. Trick said, who said you watch battle rap? That's a horrible
crazy,
question.
Crazy, right?
Because
of Trick and a verb? No, listen.
He thought
I wasn't going
to
bring a verb up. Hey, I thought I had some shit, GDV. Nah, but niggas always be like, yo, even if you don't know battle rap, you know who Murder Mook is. She don't even know Murder Mook, bro. So for all you niggas who said
that's
Murder Mook
is
a list, never
mind. That big.
Never mind.
Yo, look, that's because battle
niggas
rap niggas is not that big. Hey, watch this. Hey, Shay, do you watch sports?
I watch basketball, football. I used to play volleyball, so I like going to volleyball games and stuff.
All right, you
don't know volleyball.
But you don't watch. Hey, watch this. But you don't watch baseball, right?
I do. Sometimes my brother plays baseball.
That's your trash.
But you don't like. Okay, so do you know who Derek Jeter is?
Yeah.
Exactly. And there's my point. That's my. She knows exactly who Derek Jeter is. And she don't watch baseball, but she doesn't watch battle rap. She doesn't know who's in battle rap. That's because battle rap ain't as big as people like to make it think. Nobody knows who these battle rappers are. Am I lying?
No, you ain't lying at all. You don't know them, nigga.
Yeah.
Am I lying? I like battle rap. Don't trust
battle rap and
I like
mean,
battle rap. We
same,
all like it.
Same tier.
But y'all not going to know my favorite artist either. So, I mean, it's cool. I'm not judging y'all. Y'all can like it because I like some really outlandish shit.
What'd you like?
Try click it, yeah.
No.
Hold up. But yeah, hey, battle rap's not cool, Trigger. That's all I'm gonna say.
Okay. Shit. Just asking. No hard feelings or anything like that.
I just wanna know who her favorite rappers are.
Yeah. Kendrick Lamar?
I like Kendrick. He's cool.
That means no. That means no.
No,
I do. Fabulous.
That means
so
she
like
knows about three songs. She knows about three songs. Okay.
You like Fabulous?
Man. Anyways, I know
like
more than three
like
songs.
Fabulous,
I know at least 4.5. Okay.
Wow.
Wait. You like Fabulous?
He's a really nice dresser.
That's enough.
He also hits women.
He does.
All right.
But
did you say, hold on, Trey? Really? Did you?
Here we
you
go.
You was there? You was there when Fabulous hit his girl?
No, listen. I'm not there, but like.
Were you there?
On, that's not.
Jesus Christ.
So are you saying that he didn't do it?
That's exactly what I'm saying. You want to know why I'm saying that? Because
were you
actually,
there?
No, he's Dominican.
Were you there?
Hey, hold on. He's half Dominican, so I'm pretty sure he did it. I'm almost positive he did it. But people were on the timeline saying he knocked her teeth out. I have yet to see a picture of her without her teeth. I didn't see the internet gets everything, right? The internet gets everything.
Hey,
we have
fact,
yet to
bro.
See her without her teeth. We have yet to see him like
hey,
get
that's
arrested.
That's not the point, bro. That's not the point. I'm not. That's not the point we're making. Like, Nah, hit her, but he ain't not gonna teeth out like people said. Like, that's what she said. He hit her, but he ain't not gonna teeth out like everybody said. Like, man, he fucking hit her, man. Like, no.
How do we know that?
How do you know he did it?
Oh, you just said you believe he did it. Look, what we did see was him tell her father, "I got a bullet with your name on it." That's what I did.
Hey, he would have told me that shit. I would have been on site, bro.
Fab was on some coke that day. He said, "I got a bullet with your name on it," and she's still with him. So
that's,
for any ladies out there, look. If he did hit her that time, this is not the first time that he hit her. Not saying that that's all right, but if you stand after he been putting his foot in your ass, I don't know what y'all are going through, but that's not all on him. If you still stand while he's whipping
your ass,
that's a fact. You know what, Clea?
Yes,
I feel like
it is,
because
listen. Now I'm talking. You're going to listen. Anyways, a woman is more likely to lose her life after leaving. It has been proven. I've done case studies. I've witnessed case studies because I've been going to school for family law, things like that. So I see how domestic violence works. I see all of that. So telling a woman, how come you just don't leave, that her leaving could be her closer to dying. Like, a woman was murdered at a fucking gym because the dude she was with and left.
You said at the gym?
To be honest, at the gym. He came, he stabbed her a whole bunch of times.
Hey, Clay, front and center, man.
Yeah, man. Like, yeah. I'm saying, look, if you, maybe that has happened. Like, I'm not saying that you're, like, we're just debating. I'm not saying whether you're right or wrong or I'm right or wrong. What I'm saying is, yeah, you might get killed after you leave, or the percentage might go up. But even staying in that situation, what is that doing to the kids? What is that doing to yourself? What is that doing? Like that's hurting more than just. I mean, you don't know what's gonna happen if you leave. You don't know.
Hold on. But at the same time, right? Let's be real. Like, all right, if a man, all right, y'all got problems. Like, on some real shit. That's not. It's not that easy just to walk away from shit, though, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, if my wife fucked me up, I'd probably still be here tomorrow and shit. Like, real shit. Because, like honestly.
I mean, that's why I'm here.
But listen, I'm going to tell you why, though. I'm going to tell you why. Honestly, though. Like, so if me and my wife got into an altercation, right? And for one, I feel like as a man, I can beat your ass. I already know that I can fuck you up. You know what I'm saying? If you whoop me, bro, I probably wake up and still be here tomorrow, because first of all, me and my wife been together since teenagers. So, nigga, I love her. I don't know if I can just wake the fuck up and just be like, all right, I'm about to leave this bitch, and I'm not going to love her no more when I wake up. So I think I think women still have an emotional attachment.
That ain't got nothing to do with love, though.
But hold up, Clint.
Hold on. It doesn't have to do with love, bro. It doesn't have to do with love, but because it's not like because that incident happened,
attachment.
You're going to wake up and you're not going to love them. You still have an emotional attachment to them. You're still going to love them when you wake up the next day. That shit just don't go away. It is not that easy to walk away from it.
No, I guess
you can love them. If he's whipping your ass, or she's whipping your ass,
yeah,
you can love them from over there.
I was going to ask that. Like, at a certain point. Hold up, Trick. Like, at a certain point, like, when is it acceptable that
it's never,
you can put
it's
hands
never,
on her?
It's
right,
never
so
acceptable.
For example, Kligger.
Yeah.
Old girl tried to stab Kligger one time. You mean to tell me?
No. Hey, it wasn't. She didn't try to. She did.
Okay.
And I got arrested.
Yeah, but you mean to tell
and
me
that, and that's wrong.
His life?
No, listen. What I'm saying is, I'm not saying that it's never fucking acceptable. Domestic violence is never acceptable. I'm just saying why women sometimes stay. It's an emotional attachment, I think. Yeah, y'all just had an argument, or he just put his fucking hands on you. It's not my place to say whether you're right or fucking wrong for staying. I'm just saying, like, I'm just giving a reason of why women may stay. Through all of that shit, you probably still have an emotional attachment. When you wake the fuck up tomorrow, you're still probably going to want to be. You probably don't want the situation, but you probably still want to be with him, like, in a relationship. You probably still love him. That shit matters.
Yeah, but that's the same as just getting in getting out of a relationship to begin with. You just getting hemmed up. So how is it different?
What do you mean getting hemmed up by who though?
Like the female. Like you gonna go through the same shit regardless. You know.
So what does that say about your next relationship? Because you've just been scarred after you leave that one. So what's going to happen in your next one? Are you just going to go through your next? You going to go through your next relationship feeling like that?
Yeah, hey, but you
hold on, bro.
You scarred regardless.
Ain't no way a female is just gonna just stab me or put a gun on me. I'm just gonna be like, ah, she just mad. We gonna wake up tomorrow. And she'll be okay.
No.
That's
not about to happen.
Nah, but that's how it is. Cause I got a homeboy who said, "Yeah, man, I woke up one day. She had a knife in my chest, and the gun was right next to her." And I was like, "And you stayed with her?" He was like, "Yeah." He was like, "Yeah, that's my bitch." I was like, "You retarded, bro."
So let me put it like this right here.
Yo,
let's say you got a girl.
Hey, wait, hold on.
You and your girl.
Hey, go ahead. Go ahead, my bad.
let's say you and your girl get in the fight, right? But this time, you're the offender. You smack the shit out your girl. Do you expect her to leave you the next morning? Are you going to hold yourself accountable and be like, I think you should leave me? Or would you try to get her to stay, though you fucked up?
Not if if I'm an abusive-ass motherfucker, I don't give a fuck what she does. But if I did it like on some reaction type of my bad, like, damn. Because shit happens
sometimes.
I'm not saying you're abusive.
It's not, you're not consistently, you being abusive isn't consistent. You just have a bad night one fucking day and you decide, shit, I'm going to put my fucking hands on her. At the end of, if that's your first time, do you expect her to leave?
That sounds crazy.
Would you tell her to leave? That's how shit happens. It's just, it starts somewhere.
Hey, exactly. Exactly what J Mac said happened to me. I woke up. This was in like 2006. Shorty was wilding about something or other. I don't even remember what it was. And me being me, we have gotten into arguments all the time, a lot of times. Nothing ever happened. We just yell, blah, blah, blah. But that particular day, she's in the kitchen, and I'm like, yo, like, what the fuck are you, what you grabbing a knife for? You ain't about to do shit. And this is back in the reckless days. I'm like, you ain't about to do shit. And she stabbed me, and I got arrested and had to go through this whole little case thing. And nothing ever happened because, obviously, I didn't do shit. And she stabbed me, and the cops is like, yo, why you bleeding? I'm like, why you think I'm bleeding? I never said she stabbed me. She told them that she stabbed me, and I didn't do shit, mm-hmm. but they still arrested me. Mm-hmm. So I don't know, man.
So for some reason, police always think that men are always the aggressors, which is not the case. Which is why
dating a black woman, and if it's not a black woman, because the girl wasn't black, just like my wife is not black, but people might look at it and be like, oh, shit, aggressive in any situation. Right, mm-hmm. there you go.
Right.
And that's...
But good, I'm sorry.
You're good. Which is why I'm also very vocal about men's rights as well, because a lot of times, women are abusive towards men. They do hit men. They do whatever. But then the second the man lays a finger on them, they want to scream domestic violence. But it's like if the girl is, you know, beating you, having a knife or gun, like, you know, stabbing you or trying to shoot at you, and you end up knocking her out, I think you're doing it because you want to save your life. Doesn't make hitting wrong, nope, but she would not have gotten hit, not kicked out or whatever, had she not tried to end your life. Does that make sense?
Now, you were saying that women, a lot of women lose their life after getting out of a relationship, like an abusive one. Why is that the case?
Out of abusive one, it's... Some cases, it's a if I can't have her, no one else can type thing, where men feel like, or not men, because it could be, you know. Okay, so when a woman leaves the relationship, the person she's with often feels, oh, if I can't have her, no one else can. There's been cases where, like, a woman had got a divorce, she had a Christmas party, her ex-husband came and killed everyone in the Christmas party.
Yeah, I seen that. But my problem with that is though, like, you don't got no brother, no daddy, no nigga used to fuck with, like, no police officer you could have called.
It's the legal. It's not that it is the legal system. The legal system is fucked up. You can't say I'm lying about that because a white guy can rape somebody and do 6 months. His sentence would be 6 months and only serve 3, whereas a black person could have like a gram of weed. Now they in jail for life. You feel me?
Fact.
So there's so many discrepancies within the legal system that need to be fixed, and the best way to do that is to kick all the crooked people out now, but we can't do that because they are the majority.
That's
so we
true
can't
too,
say, oh, but why didn't you call the police when the police are, you see how police treat people?
What I'm saying, that like, she ain't had no brother, no daddy, she had no uncle, no cousin, like nothing. You didn't call nobody. Like, my sisters and shit know. Nigga touched them, they know what's going to happen. It's a phone call away.
Some people don't have that, though. Because oftentimes, manipulative relationships, they cut off contact with your friends. They cut off contact with your family, so you can't get into contact with them.
Hey, Click.
Yeah.
People describing you as wide now?
Wait, hold on. We're going to get to that. I got a question. So, question, right? Can you hear me?
Sort of on that
topic, you driving, just like Chris Brown and Rihanna were.
Rihanna.
He probably was driving. Rihanna, okay, so you know how, we all know how West Indian females are. She probably told him to go suck his mother. She probably called him a mother skunt, all type of crazy, wild West Indian stuff, and she was hitting him, obviously. And
see,
he's driving. What is he supposed to do in that situation?
The cases said that she was hitting him, he was hitting her, but again, because he is a black male, you know, it doesn't make, you know, again, violence is violence and all that stuff. What is he supposed to do?
Why was he arrested if she wasn't?
Because he's black. Because he's black and he's a male.
Jesus. He had to go through all of that. Now, again, we don't know to the extent. Obviously, she had her, but we don't know to what extent that he didn't stop or whatever. But I guarantee you she was hitting him first. No doubt in my mind.
It's not I mean, the cases say that he had bruises too because she was, I think, biting him or hitting. Someone was biting whoever and all that stuff. And it's like, people, so Chris Brown, to this day, he still criminalized all that stuff. But again, like, so when Solange fucked Jay-Z up in the elevator, how long was...
Jay-Z didn't do nothing back.
He's a lot better man.
Look, let me tell you something right now. If me and my wife get into an argument, right, or whatever the situation is, and we get into an elevator and her sister starts hitting me or doing that, I'm knocking her the fuck out. Listen to me. There's no way in hell that's acceptable. You see how Solange was hitting him, and the females didn't say nothing about it. But they saw Ray Rice hit his wife, which is terrible.
Just continue.
And everybody was up in arms. Solange was like,
Ray Rice dragged her out the elevator. She was flat.
Bro, she was asleep. She was asleep, though.
He needed to get her out of the elevator. He was helping her
out.
Hold on.
That's my point. Hold on. Hey, GDB, that's my point, though. If he'd have left her in the elevator asleep, a nigga could have came pick her up. He at least took her to the hotel room. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, somebody could have came and raped
her.
He could
at least pick her up. He dragged her out the elevator, yo. Like,
Damn.
Hey,
you
know, I'm not laughing at domestic violence at all. But that video, Ray Rice, she hit him first. and he just uppercutted shorty, and she went down, and he dragged out of the
elevator. Yeah, bro, but
that was fucking the
worst part was the elevator was closing on her, and he had to open it back up.
Hey, I'm not laughing at that. That's not funny. I ain't laughing at that.
I like how y'all are saying, oh, I'm not laughing at it. Then like 2 seconds go by, y'all all start laughing at all over again.
Because, no, I'm laughing at the double standard. Nobody said, look, when we saw Solange hitting Hov, everybody, all the females said, oh, well, what did he do? No one ever says, well, what did the female do? Exactly.
Right.
No one ever says, I'm not saying it's okay to hit anybody. But no one ever says, what did the female do? Everyone always says, well, she was hitting him for a reason. Was she? Is that her husband?
No.
A lot of people do. Oh, I'm a girl. You can't hit me. While she's literally punching the dude in the face. So some people rely on, I'm a girl. You can't hit me, which is wrong. People do grow up on the pretenses with, oh, I'm a girl and you're a guy, so I'm going to hit you and you can't do anything about it. Nah, don't put your hands on people. Like, I'm a very big believer. I'm not about to go up to Kligga and punch him in his forehead because I know if he wanted to, he could flick me across the wall.
Right.
Like,
That's exactly what Whoopi Goldberg said.
Yeah, but
that's exactly what Whoopi Goldberg said on The View, and they snapped on Whoopi Goldberg because she was like, "If you don't," she said,
"she's telling the truth."
Domestic violence, right? She said domestic violence or any type of violence is not okay, which is cool. That's why I tell people, even on Twitter, I don't care if you're a grown man and you weigh 120 pounds. When I beat the shit out of you for what you said, I don't want to hear Kligga, chill, he's smaller than you, or he's this and the third. No, he's going to be held responsible for the same shit that anybody else would be, just like a female. Again, I'm not saying it's okay or you should wow out and just beat a female up, but you have to know that whole bullshit about a man should never hit a female. No, tell that female she should not be. That's what if me and my wife ever have a daughter, or when we have a daughter, I'm going to tell her, first of all, ain't no dude hitting my daughter. You know how I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nobody doing that. But in any event that she gets into a situation, I'm going to tell her, look, don't hit no man. Or you're going to have to be prepared for me to kill him for him hitting you.
Yeah.
Right. And you
but
don't want to lose
that.
There's
always that narrative.
Right.
There's always that narrative that like with the salon shit, it was just hearsay what happened, but it was the main thing was Solange did that because Jay-Z was cheating on Beyonce. But after that, there wasn't any truth, like there wasn't any resolution on what the case really was.
All right, y'all, do you see how the Chris Brown Rihanna situation? No one was in the car. There was no cameras in the car. Whatever, whatever. People still demonize, criminalize, whatever Chris Brown to this day. Even Rihanna came out and said, "I forgive him." Whatever, whatever. All that stuff. Now the Beyonce, Solange, Jay-Z situation. There was video cameras of, you know, just showing her wilding out, hitting him, or whatever. No one said a thing. I commented on this on Twitter. No one said a thing about her being an abuser. She is an abuser.
Mm-hmm.
And if you want to call it what you want to call it, that's what she did. She, you know, abused Jay-Z. She was fighting him, hitting him, doing all that stuff. And he didn't lay a finger on her. Now, had he mushed her or slammed her against the wall, everybody would have been like,
hey.
Jay-Z that.
My problem with the Beyonce, not Beyonce, the Ray Rice and Chris thing, Rihanna, first Rihanna said, shit, I forgive him and I want to be with him. And then Ray Rice's wife said, nah, he shouldn't be charged. I still love him. We together. So when those two comments both come out, that's what I'm saying. When those two comments come out, everybody talking shit, talking about he a bad man, do that, don't let him in leave. Shit need to go away right then and there. Because if she say it's okay, leave the nigga alone.
Yeah, but you don't know if it really is okay.
But say, bro,
yeah.
It's not.
You don't
bro.
You don't know if it's not okay either, though.
But check this out. Check this out. When you in the limelight like that, there's a lot of PR moves that are made to quiet shit like that down. So you don't know if they really felt like, nah, it's okay. You know, he deserved to sleep me. Like, nah. Like, there had to be like, hey, you gonna make sure that this shit all right, and I'm going to toss you some bread or something. You know, because I don't think if you get slept like that, you just going to wake up the next morning and be like, yeah, I deserve that. Let me go marry this man.
Nah, I ain't saying she deserved it. I ain't saying that's what she said, but I'm saying if y'all still together with that many people watching, that many people on your side, and then you come out with your face clear, not a scratch on you 2 days later, and then you tell the world, say, I still love him, that's still my husband. Hey, she could have got a lot of shit out of that moment, but she said, that's still my husband. Same as Rihanna.
I mean, that's how some people are. But there's different, I mean, because you don't, everyone's situation is different, so you don't know the certain variables that go into them being the way that they are, the certain variables that go into said relationship. We only really see what they allow us to see.
That's true. Because, like, I got this one homegirl, she bashed her baby daddy from sun up to sun down on Instagram live stories. I'm like, he done beat me up. I got bruises. He did this to me, this and that. And then 2 days later, she's sucking a nigga dick. And I'm like, why are you mad about the nigga then? Why are you telling us he beating you up, showing us your black eye, your bruises, and all this and that, and then you sucking his dick 2 days later?
That's very common.
Yeah.
It's very common.
Hell yeah.
I mean, it doesn't matter, right?
I had tweeted about that before. I think I was like, I want to say like 24. But again, this was in the reckless days. My homegirl was telling me about her baby that was, she was pregnant and her baby daddy was like hitting her and shit. And this is our homegirl. You know what I'm saying? So with me, especially back then, man, it was a different time in my life. Back then, it was on some like, if I see son, I don't care where it is, I'm popping on him. And it just so happened to be she invited me to her baby shower. And lo and behold, he's at the baby shower, of course, because that's his kid. And I beat him up at the baby shower. I apologized after to her, but she got mad at me. I was like, yo, I understand that I ruined this situation. But you can't tell me that you are homegirl. Like, you are a little sister, and he's beating you up. And what you think? What am I supposed to do? Wait till we get outside? Nah, because he might not be around when I see him later. So yeah, I did him dirty in that baby shower, filthy. And she got mad at me. I'm like you better take these diapers and shut up and tell little man I love him.
Man, hey, we got 15
after that.
Minutes,
hey,
so quick. Yeah, go ahead.
No, my bad. Go ahead.
Nah, so what's this shit about you being wide, Pause?
I don't know. I think guys on Twitter, they don't know how to, like, maybe show appreciation without being weird. I don't know, man. It'd be some weird comments that I get, and it'd be men. The one dude posted a waist up a nude. Telling about his progression. I'm like, yo, son, how you posting your upper body in my mentions? What? And then I said something. I was like, come on, son. And he was like, nah, bro, I'm just trying to show you my progression. I'm like, I don't care about your progression, big dog. I don't care. Nobody cares.
Maybe he just want to be all buff like you.
Yeah, he inspirational.
Yeah, but why? I don't... Trig, you be liking that way too much. And Trig will egg these dudes on. Like, he'll see something.
Keep going.
And look, this is exactly how it works. I'll post something, and some dude will say something wild. Like, what the dude say? He said my mouth is watering. Dude said my mouth is watering.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
To your meat tip. Pause.
Hey, and I won't say nothing, thinking that nobody's seen it. But certain people in the group see everything. There's certain people in the group that see everything. So I just, like, keep scrolling, and I won't even pay attention to it. And lo and behold, I see Trig like, hey, so what you mean by his – by his back is wide. What do you mean by that?
But look,
Noodle say something back.
Hey, but look, Clig.
They said Clig was an Escalade. I said, whoa.
I was like, hey, dude was like, Clig was like 16 wide. I was like, damn. So he kind of like a Honda, huh? I told Quig, I was like, Quig, I'm about to egg it on. Quig talking about, please don't. I'm like, nah, fuck that. After all the shit you put me through, fuck this.
Hey, Quig.
I was like, Trick, do it.
He said you Luke Cage? You look like Luke Cage?
What?
Yeah,
that's what he said.
You. CDP direct.
Yo, he did. He said Luke Cage. I could find it, but I'm not going to do it. Fuck y'all.
I got a question.
Yeah, go, Shay.
Quigger, do you really get mad when the ladies call you thick on the TL?
Jesus.
What? I don't know. Sort of, kind of, and you do that shit all the time because you know it's annoying as hell. And then the more I say it's annoying, the more you do it. I don't know. I think women, I get annoyed because women want men to be like women sometimes. Like, don't smack no dude's butt. Don't call him thick. I saw a girl tell a dude that she wanted to get him pregnant. I was like, wait, what the fuck is going on? No. Don't tell no dude you want to get him pregnant. I don't know.
Why not?
I don't know.
That's wild.
I don't know. And don't call me thick. That's crazy. No dude should be getting called thick.
All of y'all who ain't me, y'all can call Clay the thick because I'm the only one that could do it. Because I said
I'm not going to do that anyway.
Yeah. I'm off track. I'm
off track.
No. I'm way ahead of you.
But like that's
J-Mac, right?
So being a guy is way different than being a girl, because I could be chilling with my girls and she'll be like, hey, look at my bra, it's cute, and she'll just like lift up her shirt and show me her bra. Y'all can't be like, oh, y'all, bro, look at my boxers and just pull your pants down, because that's mad weird if y'all were to do it. You feel me?
Ain't gonna be none of that.
That's 100%.
200%, bro.
These certain things, we can't even say certain things to each other.
You kidding me?
Hell
no. I know. I like being a girl because I can, like, I have a work wife. All right? So I went to go get my check for my job, and she saw me. The first thing she did was, like, put her head on my boobs and go, oh, my God, they're like pillows. Y'all can, like, grab each other's dicks and shit. Yeah. She could do that.
Jesus.
Yeah, but can your male work friend do that?
Nah, because I'll stab him.
No. Right.
It's a whole lot of no better at my job. A whole lot.
We got to start wrapping up. Pause.
I'm not wrapping up.
I don't know where to end this off at. Y'all just
found out. That was
Clay, you got
any
parts, man?
Yeah, again, Shay, we appreciate you coming on, giving a female point of view on domestic violence. That was like a good segue, like, from what we were talking about into that, because we would have just been talking about it from like a male point of view on like domestic violence, but you were able to give it a female's point of view, and the fact that you like study that type of thing, as well as serial killers. We'll get into that on a follow-up episode, your love for serial killers and shit like that. But we definitely appreciate that. Be on the lookout for our last episode. What was that one called? The last episode that we did?
Room Shaker.
The Room Shaker's one. That's probably one of my favorite episodes besides this one. The Room Shakers one. Be on the lookout for, shout out to to Swaggy C, Venom and Cardi would like to do, you know what I'm saying, a little segment on Big Brother. Never seen the show, but Swaggy C is on there, and you know what I'm saying, we support anybody that supports us. I don't know if Swaggy C supports us, but we're going to support anyway. So they're going to do that, and as always, hey, man, I appreciate y'all boys.
Hold on, Clear. I got a one wild last question for Shay. Shay, you ever, as a dude ever attempted to start fucking, you didn't take the rubber off and then keep going and you didn't know, but he knew?
Oh, yeah. You muted.
Yeah.
You muted, J-Mac.
Find out next on Dragon Ball Z.
That was a yes? You said yeah?
Yeah, Jesus Christ.
So thank y'all for having me. We could find out about that on the next episode, and that could be our segue into serial killers. How about that?
Yep. Hell yeah. Right. Somebody that did that and leads in serial killers, right?
Hey, Trigg, what you got to say?
Man, I just want to say that I've taken a rubber off before. You know what I'm saying? But
this nigga right here, that is a charge. Do you know that?
It was my wife.
Is it? What
that is a charge, yes. Yeah. That is charged. You can be charged with rape. Oh, my God.
Rape?
What? Yes.
Let me ask the timeline. Hold on.
So let me ask you this. Be right back. Hold on. So if I hit it raw
because,
and I put the rubber on, is that rape too?
No. Okay, so let's say a woman agrees to...
I really want to
punch you. No. Let's say a woman agreed, yes, we can have sex, but you have to wear a condom. If you're like, yeah, I'm going to wear the condom, whatever, but you take the rubber off without her knowing, she was under the false pretenses that it was going to be protected.
Where's the contract, man? Well, it is protected. I like
that.
Right? Yo.
It's not do anymore.
I locked the door. It's protected as shit.
And because it's not what she agreed to anymore. So,
wow, shit.
Nah, man, but look. Follow me on
that's
Twitter,
a,
man.
That's a textbook definition, okay? I'm just giving y'all what a textbook is giving me.
I'm just about to quit fucking because it's too much technicality for this shit, bro. I'm just gonna do what I did earlier. I'm just going to do what I did earlier. Like, this is bullshit. Like, I'm not about to be going through all this. Like, bitch, I'm gonna need a contract to fuck. You know what I'm saying? Like, but
yeah, do whatever. That because if she signs it and all that stuff, she can't say this never happened or I didn't agree to it.
I'm gonna force that shit.
No, oh my god, somebody.
I mean, I got a wife, so it really don't matter. You know, there ain't gonna be no fucking condoms. Like, I can't be like, all right, baby, I'm wearing a condom tonight. She'd be like, nigga, what the fuck? Like, you know what I'm saying? But that's all I gotta say, man. Shout out to all the people that support us. You know what I'm saying? If you don't, fuck you. Follow me on Twitter, YoungSun05.
No,
add me on. Add me. I got. Crazy. You see my followers. Follow me on you know, that other place that I said last time. I won't get into that, but follow me up there too. Oh man, that's it, man.
Boy,
I have nothing else. I have nothing else, bro. Shout out to my man GDP, shout out to my boy Quig, my boy Cardi, my boy Venom, the whole What We Doing Here movement, man, everybody, man, y'all my bros. Appreciate you.
Yeah, shout out to Shay. All right.
Thank y'all for having me.
Bet.
All right, cool, for sure. Thank you. Just let me know when y'all want to have part two.
All right, bet. We out of here.